Thank you so very much, the choir. I pray God Almighty will continue to bless you more abundantly. And the Spirit of God will not depart from you. Hallelujah! 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 We give God all the glory. We thank and glorify the Lord for yet another opportunity for you and I to appear in His presence this morning. And we pray that as we have found time, as we have kept every other aspect of our lives on hold, to come and appear before Him, all our efforts will not be in vain.
Amen.
Go to the book of Psalm 8, Psalm 8, 3 from verse 4, or verse 3. You don't know what you have.
What is man?
What verse are you reading from?
4.
Read from 3.
When I consider
that. Only more super. Only more she knew about. But you go go on back. Go out with the small way near. I consider the sun and the moon, and I see how glorious they are. I see the mighty work that they do. Yes, you did not give them as much glory as you have given unto men. Oh, it's men. That they are near in your heap. Who is men? Why do you cherish men so much? Enter.
When I consider the heavens,
only alone, hallelujah. Because if you don't know where you are with God, if you don't know your position with Him, and then you are more in God, only the Bible you put out and I'm sorry for speaking like that. If you don't know the value, your value, then you will not have any reasons to be thankful. Probably why you're not thankful is because look in your pocket and you didn't have enough to last you for the day. So, we got life. And when there is life, plenty of it. There is plenty of hope. When you still live, and don't you need to anticipate. But when you have life, there is not just hope, there is plenty of hope. And considering yourself like, I don't have anything, but I want me, and I want that. That is man no more. A madman sitting somewhere, you are better than a madman that open a man when he misbehaves, they take it, child, then he will behave. That's a human being too. But you are not in that position. There are some people that are laying down, they are helpless, they can't feed themselves. What they do on in here, they call them human beings, but they can't feed themselves. And when they say, count the people in this house, why count? No, wait here. I don't know how many people are in that house. When they're counting, and those people who are struck out, so that they struck out will be counted as many or two. But they don't need that to show away. And you're saying you don't have a reason to praise God. When someone laying next to you cannot even move their feet. You know the prayer they're praying? They're praying, God made me look at that man, that broke. I don't want to use the word. That broke man. Make me like him, check him that be, and I've been told you, he doesn't care what situation you are, but because you are able to go to the kitchen and open the fridge and drink, you don't even have money to buy soda, you are drinking water. Check him, you know, only in the kitchen, the moment, last time you conga. I just want to drink from the well like that man. You don't want to wait until it is that bad before you appreciate God. It was by the grace of God. And when the time was right, it happened. 1 Samuel chapter 10, read from verse 10. 1 Samuel 10.
And when they came to the hill,
behold, this was someone that he didn't know what it felt like, what it would feel like to prophesy. Because it was says he would lead. They had not been to the prophet's house. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
I'm praying and I'm asking for such favor upon your soul today in Jesus' name. You can claim it if you want it. Such favor. Unmerited favor. Tell you what she says. I pray for such upon your soul.
Amen.
mighty name. Amen. Because it don't need me more. If you have the Holy Spirit, you have everything.
Yes.
Sabrina.
A company of prophets met him, and the spirit of God came upon him, and he prophesied.
And he prophesied among them. And what happened?
Oh, yes. And I came to pass, when all that knew him before the God,
when they saw what happened to Saul, the people with him said, they put on their glasses. What did they say?
Behold, he prophesied among the prophets. Then the people said one to another,
they must have found our weeping.
What is this that is come unto son of
Kino Shelley, you know? Son of what?
Kish.
Kino Shelley, son of what? Bend your time as you wonder.
Yes.
That is the same way your enemy will be perplexed.
Yes.
At the service of today in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You better claim it. I don't have no power to give anything. But you are standing in the presence of Jehovah. He said, where two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in their midst. Yes. They said, what is this that has happened to Saul, the son of Kishi.
He saw also among the prophets.
Thank you. God bless you. And that was the only time the Bible records Saul ever giving message. The same way God worked that miracle in the life of Saul, it transformed him. If we go to the second lesson is also talking about transformation, but we'll get there in a minute. He told him, they said, when the Lord sighed, the Bible says, when the captivities of Zion was returned, we were like those then. I wonder if they told Lala. When your enemy see you after the service, they will be like those that dream. Because the Lord will have transformed you. Through his power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. So do not relent your effort in praising God. One thing I want you to understand is, if you don't praise him, it does not relegate God in any way. If you think, John, it does relegate him. He is still the God of yesterday, today, and forever. So, what is he losing? Oh, nature went to a book, hallelujah. I'm not going to talk hallelujah because I want it to be, his rights to be reduced. What? You need to just know that it is, when you praise God, it is a win-win situation. And God is a win-win, it's always a win-win situation. God cannot lose anything. And when they are praying for you, you refuse to say amen because you don't like the person that is rendering the prayer. Look at God, I don't like him. You don't say amen. God is not losing anything. He's not losing anything. Are you for real? God is not losing anything. You are supposed to say amen regardless because he is calling upon the name of the Lord. I don't like that prophet. Really? Is he working for himself?
No.
As long as the Lord lives and he is a prophet of God, when he is praying, just be saying amen for your own good. When he is leading a job, need to leave the they ask them to distribute fruits because the person don't like his one bringing. Don't go ask them. You cross like this so that you can take it to the end on by nowhere and show more pictures. That person you decide you have now chosen to receive it from, do you know what he or she is made of? You don't. And don't show because you don't like that person and it's the one handing it over to you, and because it is for the Lord, take it with all your heart and eat it. The good thing is, if somebody hides behind darkness and profess God, God will hearken to that prayer because his name is involved.
Yes.
But that person will be punished for all these iniquities. So because of his grace and his mercy, because his name is called. The Bible says the name of the Lord is the tower of strength. The righteous enters and he is saved. Hallelujah. So when now somebody says, Lord God, yes! What did you do? He has not become one former man. Carry on. He's not saying, Lord God, Moses. He's not saying, Lord God, David. Lord God, Jesus. Even if he's former man, Ami is not Christ. Only push hallelujah. Oh, it's hallelujah.
Hey,
push your womb on the womb. We're not asking to bring money. Say hallelujah. Like they're asking you for money. They're not asking you for money. They're asking you to praise the Lord. So when I said earlier, to whom much is given, much is expected. Now we're gonna together today to praise the Lord. And you are standing like you are somebody. I'm standing like I'm somebody. Someone that can just lay down the next minute and don't get up again. One thing you cannot do is you can't bury yourself. As good as you are, you're not going to be the one to buy your coffee. As very special as you think, oh, when I die, no matter what instructions you give them, that is how superior God is. No matter what instructions you give your family, and I think back in Kitty Golly Consimisti, that is if they are together.
Oh yes.
It's currently here. That is if they are still intact. All the money you give them to make a special place for you. If the first one is, if it's not in shape, and they collect all the money, and they feel that we don't want people from the outside to see that we are fighting. Leave them, let them carry all the money. Let's do it somewhere else. What should my sister will be in here? What will you do? But while you are alive, give God the best. Because you don't know what will happen when you are no more. Everything that comes after death, the Bible says there is no forgiveness. There is no repentance in the grave. Everything you can do it now. Now look at you. You are saying, and it was about and told me pen. The person grabbing the pen is grabbing pen. Bad party at the end. The person grabbing the paper is grabbing paper. And they're all shaking, following you. Baba, please hold up, Baba, come here. What could I be pen here? They are forgotten the pen and paper. Baba, please, give me 1 minute. And they do all that for you. And it is time for you to praise God. You can't praise him. Our friend is from Baba, the one. Baba, they're running after you. Who are you? Baba, please show me the way. Baba, please show me the way. Tell me what to do. And when it comes to your turn, to give all honor back to the mother of all honor, you feel so special. You feel so important. The remaining time is living. The battle of Baba. You prophets and prophets, doers and visioners, a lot has been given to you. Some people call you, when they call you, they look at you, they regard you as God. Some people completely forget. When hard time comes, because we are the ones that could easily reach, they could easily touch, they could easily get. So they now bring all his glory to you. Don't abuse it. Don't let us abuse it. Amen?
Yeah.
The reason why you don't want to abuse it is new attitude of our day, that of your conscience. When your own now comes, because theirs have come and they have run to you. They are not there to idolize you, but because at that point they are perplexed. Don't take advantage. Humble yourself so that the greatest work of God, the greatest miracle will come out.
in that instance. If the glory is brought to you, collect the glory and transfer the glory to God. Because you know what? I am a jealous God. It's my glory. The work on Shisha will need to Shisha for church. Child and Bill. You see all those Child and Bill brothers? Attorneys, no, in low law. Child and Bill, at the end of their lives, what's it called? One more Child and Bill. It is not yours. How can you sell something you don't have? How can we sell something we don't have? Don't sell anything that belongs to God. Who has made you a custodian of the treasures of God? Why are you selling something you don't have? Amen.
Amen.
We're not criticizing anything or anything. We're just trying to channel the glory of God appropriately. We have to channel the glory of God appropriately. When somebody is doing sanctification and they're giving the price tag, they break it down. Say everything, Ophelia, this is not waiting. You just want to sanctify your house, the total cost is already $200. She won't get any in her feet. If they cut the spirit and put price on it, how would you arrive at $200? Read 15, 18, and 19.
Let us therefore, as men of the prophet, become minded, and if the enemy be the otherwise minded, God shall repay even this unto you.
18, go to 18.
For many work, of whom I have told.
Ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ló rìn, bẹ́ẹ̀ náà ṣe rìn. If many walk on this path that you are walking, but that are not in conformity with me.
I have told you often.
What is suffering you many times? I've told you often.
I'm not telling you even weeping.
I'm telling you. Paul knew sukun. I'm telling you because he sees this destruction. He sees this evil. And the way that the evil is being revealed to him draws him close to weeping.
That they are the enemies of the cross of Christ.
Only our way, the enemies of the cross of Christ, our attack, believe in Jesus. They are enemies unto what you believe in. So what do you think is going to happen? Who is an enemy? Well, if you Google enemy, it doesn't want to have anything with it. It does not think the way you think. An enemy is thinking a different way you are thinking. You are thinking of going to a job interview and getting the interview. Your enemy is thinking you should not get to that interview alive. If you are thinking of conceiving and having a child, your enemy is thinking you should be married. So it's what an opposite. If you Google enemy, only the enemy of the cross of Christ, hallelujah. All these things that we are seeing doesn't make any meaning to them. Such people. That is why Paul says also in Corinthians chapter 1 verse 18. He says, we renew our ability. Say unto you, O man, should one for our tea at my door? At my door. Hallelujah. They are enemies. Whatever you believe in is nothing, is not important to them. So Paul is reminding you as you bring back home today. Remember. And he said, I'm weeping, saying it. Because I know you still don't understand it. You still see yourselves in both white. And you are wearing cross like them too. You are carrying me in your chest. As carrying, but there is something that you still don't see. Your eyes cannot carry you any further than you are looking at. Because I'm wearing white next to you, and we have the same color. It's telling you, be careful.
Oluwa, this too.
Because they are walking in your midst. They are not elsewhere. How are you? You okay? Pastor, see you well. Oh, I know you well. Before you say, Satan is not in the church. Satan can sit on the altar. Challenge me. Let's discuss it. Tell me, Satan can't sit on any of these chairs. Some bad man, I don't wear it yet. Has his power been taken away yet? The Bible says, not now. Because that man sits in the altar, you think he's holier than thou. Think twice. And open, shine your eyes. Believe in him. Respect the elders. But believe in him. Respect the elders. The Bible tells us so. That's why I said, yes, even if somebody you don't like is praying for you, kneel down because he's saying, I've told us something. That you don't understand. I decree in the name of Oguno Oguno. Then you know you are going into a foreign land. Then if you now still continue to say, Allah Baeshe, that's on you. But respect the elders. Because only everyone I want, he gets to this, he says, I will now transform you. But did you read that? Lesson, 1 Corinthians 1:18. Did somebody read it? It says, the preaching of the cross is foolishness to those. I mean, 1 Corinthians 1:18. To those that will perish.
For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish.
Say it again.
For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish.
Foolishness.
But unto us which are saved, it is the power of God.
Hallelujah. But unto us which who are saved, our dear Abba. To us who are saved, Abba our Lord only. And somebody in this passage is telling us, the title of this passage is Enemies of the Cross of Jesus Christ. And people are somewhere. Finish it, and let's get out.
Whose end is destruction?
If Baruni, Beyam, when you're begging, said their end is destruction.
God is their belly.
Barely.
And whose glory is in their chain? Who mind earthly things?
Mm-hmm.
For our conversation is in heaven.
We have said it over and over these 3 days. They said they mind earthly things. And the theme of this convention is who shall ascend to the hills of the Lord. And it goes further by saying, those that have not raised up their souls unto vanity, nor sworn deceitfully. Now, this Bible that we are reading in 2nd verse, we didn't put it together, we didn't even know, but it corresponds. It says now that their minds are on earthly things. Let us rise up.
Hallelujah. I got 4 minutes. And those 4 minutes, I don't want anybody to lose out. Jesus, so we be. See how when you're covered, you're in trouble. No matter what you listen to, which is the power of God, but as man that got water and blood that runs through your veins without the practical manifestation, we still don't believe. The 12th convention. 12 means a number of completion.
Oh, Christ,
Benio.
mo pàṣẹ wípé ní òye ọ̀la mo pàṣẹ wípé ní òye ọ̀la ògùn ọlọ́run yóò fara hàn fún ẹnìkan tó bá rí àmì ńlá mẹ́ta ṣe ní orúkọ àwọn bàbá àwọn táwà dúró fún lónìí nínú aṣọ ẹ̀mú ọwọ́ táwà wọ̀ lónìí mo pàṣẹ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ aláṣẹ as a prophet of living God
the Lord Jesus
nítorí pé ẹ wá
because you came
láti láàrin ọwọ́ ọ̀rùnbùsù àti àríwá ìpadà yìí níwòye ẹ̀mí ayọ̀ ni ó jà sí ẹ̀mí ọlọ́run bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní rábà
the spirit of the Lord roving
bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní gba ìyọ̀ rẹ̀ bí nítorí sílẹ̀
náà
ọ̀rọ̀ bẹ̀ fún kọlẹ́lẹ́
incest
kọlẹ́lẹ́
it was the mama
bí kò sí ọ̀rọ̀ ọlọ́run
jáde the words of God is coming out
fún àlàáfíà fún ìwòsàn fún ìṣẹ́gun fún ìgbàlà fún ìbùkún
fi
orúkọ jésù mo bá
láṣẹ
gẹ́gẹ́ bí ọmọ aláṣẹ àní àrùn lé iṣẹ́
náà
a wípé aṣọ wípé aṣọ ṣẹlẹ̀ sínú ẹ̀yìn wípé fún ẹnìkan tó bá rí àmì ńlá kan ṣe ó bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí jẹ̀rí ọlọ́run
continue to come in at this moment let your happy consonant be to God in the moment you must receive
láti jẹ́ kẹ́ mọ̀ wípé
ọlọ́run
ọ̀ṣọ́ fàkókò nínú bíbẹ̀ ìrẹ́ àìsàn
you sickness infirmity
ohun tí kò dára
you infirmity
ìrẹ́ àìsàn
you sickness
tó wà nínú ẹ̀jẹ̀
ìrẹ́
àìsàn
you sickness
tó wà nínú omi
infirmity
mo wípé mo sọ fún
ìrẹ́
àìsàn bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí ní jáde.